behalf of the cabin crew, I'd like to welcome you aboard our flight. As you find your seat, be sure to place your larger carry-on items in the overhead bins and smaller items underneath the seat in front of you. If you have trouble finding a location for any of your carry-on items, please use the flight attendant call button over your seat and somebody will assist you. If the overhead bin is full after you put your carry-on inside of it, please close the bin as a courtesy to other passengers. Once all your items are put away, please clear the aisle and sit down in your seat to allow other passengers to find their seats as well. If you are seated in an emergency exit row, please read the exit seating responsibilities in the safety card in the seat back in front of you. Please make sure you are willing and able to perform the actions required. If you are not able or prefer not to perform these actions, please let a flight attendant know so you can be reseated. You are free to use your portable electronic devices during the boarding process. We ask that larger electronic devices are stowed once we depart from the gate. Thank you and welcome aboard. Ready to go when you are. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome aboard Flight 302 with service to Washington, D.C. Our flight time will be roughly 40 minutes. Now that the cabin door is closed, please make sure that all devices are in airplane mode and your large devices are now shut down and stowed. Please fasten your seatbelt and make sure that all tray tables and seat backs are in a full upright and locked position for departure. Cabin crew, secure doors for departure.
Kennedy Ground, Chater Julia, Tango 302 requesting the end of pushback.
Chater Julia, Tango 302 request to end pushback received.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the screen for an important safety demonstration. Thank you for flying with us.
Welcome aboard. Before we take off, we're going to give you an important safety briefing. So keep a sharp eye on the cabin crew or the screen in front of you. And together, we'll make sure that your journey is a safe one.
Every aircraft is different, so it's important to pay attention, even if you've flown with us before.
Before we take off, make sure all your cabin baggage is stowed in the overhead locker or under the seat in front of you. All electronic devices must be completely powered off for takeoff and landing. Before you do so, ensure you disable cellular, Bluetooth and Wi-Fi capability by switching to flight mode and then turning off. Fasten your seatbelt by inserting the clasp into the buckle and tighten by pulling the strap. If you are seated in first, also ensure that your sash belt is in place for takeoff and landing. Undo your seatbelt by pressing the button. You must have your seatbelt done up low and tight, including infants and children during takeoff, landing, and whenever the seatbelt sign is on. While seated at other times, we require that you keep your seatbelt fastened. And in the unlikely event of an emergency, it's important that you're familiar with the brace position appropriate to your seat. If you can reach the seat in front of you, brace by folding your arms on the back of the seat in front and rest your forehead on your arms. If you can't reach the seat in front of you, put your head on your knees or lean as far forward as you can and hold on to your legs. Keep your feet firmly on the floor to prevent them from moving forward. If you are seated in first, your brace position is to sit upright, place your hands on your knees and bring your chin towards your chest. Take a moment now to check where the nearest exits are in this aircraft as the cabin crew point them out. Be aware that your nearest exit may be behind you. A good way of remembering your nearest exit is to count the number of rows between you and that exit. Our cabin crew are pointing out the lights that show a path to the exit. This aircraft is fitted with escape slides and life rafts, which the crew will operate in an emergency. If we do have to evacuate, you must leave all items carried onto the aircraft behind. A loss of oxygen at altitude may lead to a loss of consciousness. If emergency oxygen is required, a mask will drop from above you. Pull down on it firmly to activate the flow of oxygen. Put it on quickly and tighten the strap. Oxygen will flow without the bag inflating. Once you're breathing normally, it's okay to help others. Make sure you're familiar with the location and use of your life jacket. In economy, yours is under your seat. If you're in premium economy or first, it's inside your leg rest. If you're in business, it's next to your leg rest.
Your crew member is now demonstrating how to put your life jacket on.
Remove the life jacket from the pouch by pulling the tab. Slip the jacket over your head, pass the strap around your waist, clip the waist strap together at the front, then tighten. Your life jacket comes with a red tag and a mouthpiece for inflation, and a whistle and a light for attracting attention. And remember, only inflate your life jacket as you leave the aircraft. Take a moment now to look where your life jacket is located. If you're unsure, please ask the cabin crew. Smoking is a fire hazard and is not permitted anywhere on this aircraft. This includes the toilets, which are fitted with smoke detectors. In preparation for takeoff, ensure your seat is upright and your tray table is stowed. And just in case you've missed any of this, simply refer to our safety card, located in your seat pocket.
Remember, the cabin crew are here to look after you, so follow their instructions at all times. Now settle back and enjoy your Qantas flight.
Please read the health and safety information in the onboard information section of Qantas The Australian Way magazine. This section will help to make your flight more comfortable. It also details important information on deep vein thrombosis or DVT, precautions you can take, and recommended exercises.
Tower Jeter Julia Tango 302 ready to go runway 31 left IFR to Washington.
Jeter Julia Tango 302 cleared for takeoff runway 31 left.
Cleared for takeoff runway 31 left, Jeter Julia Tango 302.
New York departure on 134.35.
134.35, Jet Air Juliet Tango 302. New York departure, Jet Air Juliet Tango 302 is at 2,100 feet, climbing 6,000 feet.
Jet Air Juliet Tango 302, New York departure, continue as planned. Altimeter 29.92.
As this is a shorter flight, we will not be able to offer in-flight service. Please let us know if there's anything we can do to make your flight more enjoyable, and we will assist you.
Thank you.
Tango 302 cleared to land runway 1. Wind 236 at 5.
Clear to land runway 1 to Tair Julia, Tango 302.
Gentlemen, welcome to Washington, D.C. The local time is 9:38 a.m., and it's currently about 68 degrees Fahrenheit. You can now use your mobile devices to remain seated until the air traffic comes to a complete stop and the seatbelt sign is turned off. Remember to use caution when opening the overhead bins, as items may have shifted during the flight. If this is your final destination, we thank you for flying with us. If you're making a connection, we encourage you to check your itinerary to ensure a smooth continuation of your journey. We apologize for the delay. Please coordinate with airline staff as necessary regarding connecting flights or vouchers.
Taxiing to gate Charlie Tree Niner via taxiway Juliet Kilo November Jeter Juliet Tango 302. Washington Ground Jeter Juliet Tango 302, could you please connect the jetway to the aircraft?
Jeter Juliet Tango 302, the jetway is going to be connected.